Hi, my name is Kamen Seagraves. I'm here representing the Ferris Group. We're going to give you a rundown of the textbook brokers business and the industry they're in and the competitiveness around it and where the future is going for this industry. So we'll first give you the key statistics and a little snapshot. So the industry, industry-wide, there is about $12 billion in revenue and only $120 million in profit. So it's a pretty small profit margin to start out with. From 2012 to 2017, as you can see, there's been negative 3.7% growth in revenue, and projected in the future is supposed to be 0.4% in the negative range. The wages in this field have been about $1.5 billion, and there's about 18,000 businesses in this industry. It's using the building blocks that we've learned through class and strategic management. So for the quality, they're selling used textbooks, and from a functionality and reliability standpoint, they're the same as the new books. So they cost a lot less, maybe around $30, where a new textbook might be $100 and $120. Costs a lot less, but has the same quality, the same reliability. Yes, they might not be brand new, but I think most students don't really care about that as much. They want the value from the book, and Textbook Brokers is providing the same value as they would with a new textbook. Their image, they're not trying to develop this, you know, used, rundown book image. They want to have that high image as a textbook distributor. They're trying to build an image of MTSU's biggest textbook broker, textbook supplier. They've done a great job with that by incorporating the apparel aspect into their business. So you walk into their main storefront on Greenland, and the first thing you see is all the MTSU apparel and Go True Blue, and get everyone all hyped up on MTSU. From a strategic arena standpoint, the college students who are broke are pretty much the main focus. As you walk around campus and talk to people, you can quickly understand that a lot of students here are working at the same time as going to school. In the past, MTSUs have that suitcase school reputation, which I don't think is as prevalent today, but there's still a lot of students that are driving in and out, they're working back home an hour away, or and they're really, you know, working on a budget, so the extra cost of a textbook is a big deal. Geographically, they're located near MTSU. They're in Murfreesboro, they're local, they have a local feel. They have two storefronts, one in Rutherford, one in Greenland. That's a big factor. The product is textbooks, so a lot of used textbooks, like we mentioned earlier, and they're buying textbooks back from students as well. So that's one of their strategic arenas, is being the broker, like the name kind of tells you. They help you find a good deal. They sell you used textbooks, which has been one of their biggest profit areas, and then they buy them back from you when you're done. So trying to add the most value at the lowest cost for students has been their strategic arena. The channels, brick and mortar, and they also use online as well, so they have relationships with Chang and Amazon for distribution. And the expertise, new used books, and then also ebooks, but like I said earlier, their expertise is, their focus is more than usually the category. Innovation, we didn't see too much innovation there. There's the brokerage idea, you know, selling used at a good value, buying it back, but not as much of an innovation company. From an efficiency standpoint, we didn't see too much investment in that area, except for they have other locations throughout the United States at different universities, so they have the systems and the logistics already down, so they can focus more on building market share and building awareness and connecting with the students in the university. So they have the textbooks coming in, now they need to focus on more the sales and the connection part. So next we're going to talk about the strengths of textbook brokers. As you can see, they have that hometown feel. So textbook brokers, unlike Follett and the Phillips Bookstore, they have that more of a connection with the students. You say textbook brokers and students are going to know who they are. They're known for adding that value and bringing the deal to students and buying textbooks back. So they've done a great job of establishing themselves in Murfreesboro as more of a local type company. Brand awareness, accessibility, so they're very accessible. They have two locations, Greenland and Rutherford, and the awareness is high as well because you actually drive by them all the time. They have a successful model that's been proven in many other markets, many other universities throughout the country. The logistics, they've got that down as well. Like previously mentioned, they know how to get the textbooks here. They've worked with Amazon and Chang, and they've got the logistics down, so that's not the problem. Marketing and social media, They've done a phenomenal job at that. If you look at Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, they do these big posts where they'll be giving away free items to students, and you have to share the post in order to gain access to that. And by doing so, you'll see textbook brokers post all over social media during big times of buying textbooks or during games and whatnot. So they're really boosting that awareness and that accessibility by utilizing marketing and social media tactics. And then again, they have the two stores, which you know, can be a strength maybe from the marketing side, but we might also see that as a weakness as well for having to pay rent in both storefronts. Go to the next one. The weaknesses. One of the big weaknesses which they're trying to overcome through this strategy is they're not on campus. So yes, they're off campus and they kind of have that brand, but one of the biggest locations for a textbook company is on campus, and that is in the Phillips Bookstore. Right now, Follett has that contract, but they're coming up with a renewal possibility, and Textbook Brokers is trying to get in that and trying to take over with the proposition that they can do a better job and provide better value and a bigger commission at TSU. They're working within a medium complexity industry, or competitive, I'm sorry, and it's a declining industry as well. Such one weakness is varied. There's a lot of companies, a lot of competitiveness. Technology has been disrupting the industry with electronic books and these integrated systems and AI technology. That's one of the weaknesses. And also, after seeing some reviews, they have a few poor customer reviews. And that's just online. I think generally for the students, it seems to be pretty good, but having a few bad reviews online can definitely negatively affect the company. There's some big opportunities up in the air right now for textbook brokers. Like I said just a second ago, the Follett Bookstore is up for renewal, and this is their chance to sneak in there and then take it if they have the good business model for it. The opportunities is to provide more value to students. So like textbook brokers told us, the publishers are trying to come in and really cut out companies like textbook brokers, and by doing so, they're going to be charging the students more money, and MTSU is going to be making a bigger commission. But who's left out? It's the students. They're losing money on that. They're going to be charged more for classes, more for tuition. That's difficult for students working on the budget. Some other opportunities are convenience. If they get in with the Phillips Bookstore, it's convenient. It's right there on campus. They have a good business model to provide successful sales. And the convenience of already having stores off campus as well, those working together work great. In other segments of the industry, there's some opportunities as well. So the electronics, the technology in the Phillips Bookstore, they sell some technology items and electronics, so textbook brokers might dive into that segment of the industry as well. Phone repairs, we've seen that in the Greenwood location. That's one of the other business propositions that you're diving into. Some of the threats is, one of the major ones, like previously mentioned, is that publishers they're coming in and they're kind of trying to push them out. So publishers are up here and they're trying to go straight to the university and give their content straight to the university and provide it through the classroom. That's a big threat for textbook brokers because they get cut out completely. The electronic books, again, so textbook brokers told us they make most of their profits and sales through used books, and they provide the most value there. With the electronic book industry, there's so much competition because people and companies can compete from all over the country that the price is held pretty stable. There is no, there's not any big differences or sways, because you go on Amazon or go on Google and you'll find a textbook for $5 less and you're gonna buy it over there. So it's one of the tougher parts of the industry. Artificial technology is a big threat. So these integrated learning classrooms where the artificial technology kind of creates the class and orients it to each individual student based on their learning needs. And then the two locations could possibly be some sort of cannibalization. So they might be pulling on each other's sales, and they're paying rent in two locations, where if they consolidated, they might have less rent and have all the sales in one location. The strategic concerns we see for textbook brokers are that the publishers are going directly to the school. So that's the biggest number one problem. Textbook brokers need to get in there and add the value, but the value they added was, in a way, defending the students. They're providing low prices for books that are high quality from the used industry. They're not used, so they cost a lot less. The AI, so We've seen GMAT. GMAT was a good example. There's been courses out there to help students study for the GMAT, and they have artificial technology incorporated to where it helps a student learn at his or her own pace. So as soon as one topic or one subject is it's been understood and they know what's going on, then it moves on to the next one. It keeps them in the same area until they've completed it. So that could be huge for the education realm, where maybe there's an instructor or professor for each class, but there's also some bit of artificial intelligence learning as well. And that might push out some of the old school textbooks or even just PDF files of a textbook. And then monopolization, we see that if the publishers come in, they in a way monopolize the textbook field. Yeah, there might be a few other textbook publishers, but you no longer have the brokers who are providing the value that textbook book is. So our recommendations at this point are to promote the current and past experience in the used book industry. Textbook Brokers has established itself with a great reputation of adding value to the students. So the example we use is they buy a book for $300 and it's used over 3 years, so it only costs them $100 a year. They charge the students $150 per year for the book, and they can profit $50 per year per book from that field. And these can be used in online sources as well. We think they should continue leveraging the hometown local image. I think Textbook Brokers is a good brand around campus, and they can promote that with the president and with the other administrators and faculty, that they are really here to add value, to defend the students, to keep those low prices that keep students coming back to the TSU. So in the future, they need to promote themselves to take over the Phillips Bookstore and brand the Phillips Bookstore with the Textbook Brokers image and logo. So right now we have the Phillips Bookstore and it's Follett, but no one really knows it's Follett, so if the Textbook Brokers can get in there, they really need to brand it with Textbook Brokers. So for our last few recommendations, we think that Textbook Brokers needs to show and display the high value of the relationship that they have with MTSU. Because MTSU might be giving some sort of contract or giving the opportunity to work with the university, and Textbook Brokers needs to continue to show appreciation for that. They've been doing a great job through providing scholarships and other opportunities for students, as well as free apparel and gear. Maybe they could do some sort of textbook incentive too, textbook scholarships, whatnot. And lastly, the big recommendation from us is that Textbook Brokers should try and position themselves as the representative of the university. So if we think that these integrated classrooms are going to come where they want to include textbooks and electronic versions of the content with the classroom, Textbook Brokers should try to position themselves in a way to represent MTSU. So the class is normally $700. The university can make the class $800. So there's a $100 spread, and then Textbook Brokers then takes that $100 and does the best job it can to provide the content textbooks to the classroom. And Textbook Brokers takes all the work off the university, and they're the one who negotiates with all the different publishers coming in and negotiates contracts and lowers prices. And that way, we still have the same concept of publishers coming and providing the content through the classroom, but the publishers can't monopolize and they can't control the university. So part of Textbook Brokers representing MTSU in the inclusion of content in the classroom would, a lot of the value comes from Textbook Brokers already having the content, already having the used books. And these books cost $150, $200. They buy that book one time and they provide the textbook in the classroom for multiple semesters in a row. That way we're still using used textbooks, and then we're taking advantage of the new form of content being provided in the classrooms. So used textbooks will get used in the fall semester, and then again in the spring semester, and in the years to come. And that price is included in the tuition. And that would be a lot less than having the publishers come in and charge $125 or $150 that they're asking for just one class. So this would give the control to the university and have Textbook Brokers representing them, negotiating prices, and continuing to use used books in the classroom where needed.